Phoenix Taxis are proud to bring you Driver, the new taxi booking app that's taking Europe by storm. You can book a cab in advance or for right away, and with credit or debit card payment and the ability to track your taxi live, it's the new and convenient way to travel with Northumberland's greenest and cleanest taxi firm. Download the app today by searching for Driver and enter Phoenix in the voucher section for £10 off your first booking.
And we're live here at St James's Park, usually home to Newcastle United, but tonight's game is between Blyth Spartans and North Shields in the Northumberland Senior Cup Final. Now, it's been a long, hard season between the two sides, and again, Blyth Spartans are here on merit after a disappointing defeat against Workington 4-3 in the playoff finals. Now, it's up to the Spartans to reclaim their glory and bring home the trophy to Blyth.
To the back post, and there's a header! Dale hit the header at the back post. Blyth Spartans 2, Newcastle United 0.
Tom, it's the cup final night, it's the last fixture of the season. Big night for your boys.
Yeah, looking forward to it. Been here before, been the last 2 years now. This is the third time we've been here. Won one, lost one, so it's a tough game. North Shields is a good side. I've got great respect for them, so it'll be a tough one, but we're looking forward to it, you know.
A lot of your lads are Newcastle fans. What's it mean to them to play at the stadium?
Yeah, they're big fans. Not many Mackens and no, thank God. But we've got one or two. But you know, there's a lot of lads working Newcastle as youngsters, so they've got a, they haven't got a point to prove. But they're looking forward to being here and maybe showing what they can do, you know.
And do you see it as a kind of a chance to bounce back after last week's disappointment as well?
Yeah, it is. You know, we look at the season overall rather than just one-off games. But it was disappointing for everybody, as well as the players, and they seem a lot happier now. There's no stress on them. Just come and enjoy the football, and whatever happens, happens, you know.
You've been around the circuit a long time, you'll know a lot about the lads in the North Shields sides. What are you kind of expecting from them?
Yeah, they'll be good footballers, very fit. They've had a bit of a fixture backlog that we had 2 years ago. And sometimes it's a big pitch that just sat the legs up here, so we've got to start sharp. But they've got some really, really talented footballers, a few ex-Blyth Spartans footballers as well. So I know Graham very well and Smithy, and I know they'll get the team up for the game, you know.
Shields in the attack, Mason prodding it forward into Ryan Carr. Carr has got Bainbridge in here. Bainbridge has to check back from the line. He's played across McHugh, had to dive on that one ahead of Carr. Bainbridge out to the left hand side, gets a return pass there, and he's coming through here. Bainbridge has managed to shake off Parker, comes towards the edge of the area. Here's Gareth Bainbridge playing it across from Ryan Carr. Nicholson feeding it back to Richardson, and now he plays a brilliant ball right from one wing to the other, to the feet of Robbie Dale. Dale with a bit of space ahead of him. quick step over to get away from his man, and he cuts back on his right foot and he curled a superb shot off the crossbar. And for all the Blyth Spartans have been on the back foot, that was a stunning effort.
So, it's shaping up to be a pretty decent contest so far.
We will have extra time and penalties, of course, if either side fails to break through the deadlock, or if it does finish level here. So it would be certainly some excitement to look forward to here at St James's Park. Ball now at the feet of Ben Richardson. Richardson midway inside the Spartans half, looking for an option, and he's managed to thread it through here to Ryan Carr. Carr's going to get to the line here, but there's nobody really in support. Bainbridge coming into the area, to the edge now with Ormston, and he's curled a superb effort. That's Adam McHugh, and more Shields take the lead here against Blyth Spartans, and it's not really against the run of play at all, is it, Luke?
No, not at all. Really deserved that. More Shields, to be honest, had a couple of good efforts. Blyth just don't look at the races whatsoever, and that was a beautifully caught shot by Gary Ormston. Just inside the edge of the area, no one really closed him down with too much gusto, and he just killed it nicely into the far corner. Great composure, great finish, and very much a deserved lead from Oxford.
Now here comes Spartans with Sean Reid, getting the ball out of his feet and real urgency about his play. He plays it to the left-hand side to Robbie Dale. Dale cutting inside on that right and then tried to get away, but the tackle there from Donison falls to Richardson. Now here's Reid on the edge of the area, and it's just gone wide. Comes just over the halfway, playing it infield now to Dale. Dale turns and plays a right-footed pass straight across to the right wing to Michael Richardson, who does brilliantly there to get away from Summery. Gets into the area now, Michael Richardson, and it slipped a shot, but it was well parried there by Chris Bannon. Good movement here from Dale. He's away from three challenges there. Now he's got Jordan Watson in plenty of space on the left, and he plays it ahead of him. Watson has to run to get to it, but he does well. Finds Damon Mullen just in field. Mullen forward to Maguire. Maguire back to Jordan Watson. Watson in field now to Damon Mullen. Mullen goes across the park, and they're starting to spread the play nicely from one flank to the other. And Nicholson's gone for a drive from miles out, and it nearly, very nearly beat Chris Bannon and crept into the corner there. It was a really good effort from Alex Nicholson. Richardson moving infield now, and then he plays it back across to the right hand side, and they're just spreading the play from side to side, trying to wear out North Shields. And Dale running towards the edge of the penalty area now, slips a lovely ball into Jordan Watson. Well saved. Dan Maguire's there to pick it up, but he just can't get the angle to get the shot in. Back to the edge of the area now to Robbie Dale. Dale coming towards the 18-yard box. He's crowded out by three red shirts. Now Matthew Wade's going to go for goal, and that's not a great effort from him. Here comes Watson down the left flank, playing it to Richardson. Richardson infield to Wade. Wade helping it on to Dale. Dale getting it out of his feet, finding Reid. Reid dropping it onto the right flank to Nicholson. Nicholson infield now to Dale. Dale just getting it onto his right boot, and he tried to get past the man. He's won a free kick just on the edge of the area, and this is definitely what you would call Robbie Dale territory. Plenty to aim at here. He's got it over the wall, and Bannon had to scramble across and tip it round the post. A good value for that lead. They've taken this one quickly, looking for the run of Bainbridge. They tried to help it into McHugh and with Buddle, and Buddle playing it out to the left hand side. North Shields being made to run from side to side here. Ball forward to Robbie Dale. Dale back here looking for Dan Maguire, and he's found him. Maguire was tripped, and it's going to be a Blyth Spartans free kick, and a chance for them to put the ball into the penalty area here.
Forcing the wingers to come in narrow, which is leaving space on
the line. With the free kick, it goes over to the back post, and there's a header, and it's in the back of the net, and it's an own goal. I think it was Matthew Wade who headed it back down into the area, and it seemed to come off Kevin Hughes, the captain, and it's ended up in the back of Chris Bannon's goal, and it's 1-1, and it's an own goal. It's given them the joy here, the Blyth Spartans. But you have to say, in the balance of play, Luke, they probably deserve to be level.
Yeah, they have. They deserve to be behind, and they deserve to be level now as well. It was a really good ball in from really good ball from Robbie Dale.
And I think he was offside, but the referee decided to go with the throw-in anyway. Ball over to the left now to Jordan Watson. Watson, plenty of space ahead of him to run into over the halfway. Plays it to Dale on the left. Dale moving away here from a couple of challenges, and plays a brilliant pass into the path of Michael Richardson. Robbie Dale's having a brilliant game. Brilliant ball in from Richardson, and it's come off the keeper. It's going to be a corner. Nathan Buddle now. Buddle continuing Blyth Spartans' tactic of spreading the play from side to side. Here's Gordon Watson on the left, playing it back and field to Matthew Wade. Wade forward to the edge of the area. Here's Dale helping it across goal to Sean Reid, who strikes, and it's 2-1. Blyth Spartans have come from behind, and now they lead here in the Senior Cup Final against North Shields. And they really do deserve to be ahead. They've been fantastic since they went down. It's been a brilliant response. Lovely work there from Dale to take on a couple of blows and find Sean Reid, who picks out the bottom corner. 2-1 to Blyth Spartans.
Yeah, really good work again from Robbie Dale, just cutting in on the flank, skips back one or two challenges, plays it off to Sean Reid, and Sean Reid seems to have his goal scoring boots on in the last month, 5 weeks or so. He's took that one beautifully in the corner. Graham Fenton really wants to get his side in for half time. He's going to commit another 3-4 minutes or so. Just seems to be wave after wave of Blyth attack, Blyth keeping the ball well.
Richardson's found Nicholson now. Nicholson playing it across goal. Maguire's coming in. Oh! It was when he had to throw himself out there, Dan Maguire, and he just got caught underneath his boots as he. Buddle, Parker, and Wade. And it comes to the head of Buddle, who flicks it over to Parker at the back. And Parker, brilliant skill, and he's in the penalty area here, just tackled. Wade tried to clip it back into the area, cut out. Now here's Mason on the left-hand side, gets away from Robbie Dale, tries to advance further. Wade going with him all the way, and Matthew Wade takes him down. It's a cynical foul there from Matthew Wade. The former Blyth player, Lee Mason. And a free kick taken quickly there by Ben Richardson down the line. Whips in from the right-hand side, and there's a good header straight into the gloves of McKee.
I feel this goal kick has got to be...
allegedly 1 minute added on.
Well,
he played three.
His timepiece is broken.
Parker has checked his watch again. Goes back out to this left-hand side. Watson putting away there from Richardson. Parker across now to Nathan Buddle. Buddle back to Parker. Parker forward to halfway to Jordan Watson. The referee checks his watch once again. And Parker's been shrugged off the ball there by Bainbridge. Bainbridge coming forward, plays it across now to the edge of the area to Lee Mason, who's curled up and thrust over the crossbar. And that was really shoddy defending. Now the half-time whistle finally goes. And Spartans take a 2-1 lead in at the break, but it could have been 2-2 there very easily.
So it's 2-1 to Blyth Spartans here at half-time at St James's Park. A thrilling first half. Blyth went 1-0 down, but roared back through an own goal after a great ball by Michael Richardson and went 2-1 up. A great turn and finish by Sean Reid. Robbie Dale has been the centre of attention. He's been magnificent. Can North Shields get back into it in the second half, or will Blyth go on and record their second consecutive Northumberland Senior Cup Final trophy?
Chasing down a ball back to the keeper by Kevin Hughes, the scorer of that own goal. He put Spartans on level terms before Sean Reid gave Spartans a much deserved lead. Parker, fourth row into North Shields on the halfway line. Here's Curtis Copper, forward to Ryan Carr. Carr helping it back now, and here's Ormston, the goal scorer for North Shields. Holmes getting a chance to run for the first time. Here's Bainbridge, across to Mason. Mason helping it across, and now here's Summer on the left hand side. He rolls it across, and it's 2-2. Here's Bainbridge in the centre row, just allowed to tuck it in the 6-yard box. And Spartans have come out rather sleepily the second half, and they've made to pay the price.
Yeah, they have really, and very good by somebody to find themselves some space over on the left hand side and get the ball into the box. And that man there, Bainbridge, just touched the ball in, so yeah, Reid just jumped it once again as they started the first half. Reid was just all over the place, and plenty of space for somebody to get the ball in, plenty of space for Bainbridge to tuck it away. Tied up at 2-2.
Oh, because it's a funny old one, really. But I started terribly, and then came out really strong. And then after the break, they've come out again looking pretty sleepy. And now here's Bainbridge on the attack again. I think he's going to go for goal. Over the top of the crossbar, fairly harmless. It's the pressure between himself and Richardson. And Shields can come forward again with Dean Holmes. First to check his run back and to Ormston. Ormston playing it forward, flicked in there by Bainbridge, and suddenly he's charging into the area. He's headed it over on the queue, Parker just able to flick it away, headed further downfield there from Buddle. But nervy moments here for Blyth at the back, just nearly getting in the end of that one. Good tackle there by Reid. Now Dale's making a brilliant run on the left hand side, lovely threaded pass from Richardson to find him.
Robbie Dale coming towards the edge of the 18-yard box here, and he runs into traffic and he's sacked down there. It's going to be a free kick for Blyth Spartans. Another chance for a free kick for Dale, and then it's over the top of the bar this time. Over to Coppin. Now, at the feet of John Parker. Parker forward in Bainbridge. He's onside here, and he's round the back, and he's looped to Sue. Over the top of Adam McHugh, and Northfields take the lead, and that is a stunning goal. Really, really good finish by Gareth Bainbridge. Turn this one round across now to the left hand side to Ormston. Ormston once more on to the left hand side now to Jordan Summerly. Summerly clipping it over the top and running in. Here's Dean Holmes, who did hit it first time. Over the top of the crossbar. Spartans again, Luke struggling to get into this one.
Comfortable on the ball.
Being allowed to play at leisure, and that's a nice ball into the path of Dean Holmes, who's very lively since coming on at half time. He's going to cross this one in and goes over the top. Here's Donison at the back post, and he struck that one over the top of the crossbar. The second substitute by Spartans, third and final substitution. It's a bit of a puzzling one there. Matthew Wade making way for Neal. They've been very frustrated out there the second half.
Yeah, it's just not fair to them. Need to make it happen a little bit more for me, not putting required work rate right into the result here tonight so far.
And 10 or 15 minutes remaining in this one. Brilliant work here from Wilson Nishaw. Nishaw bearing down on goal. Tipped away by the keeper. It's going to fall to Dale, but his back's to goal. That was a back to Richardson. Brilliant tackle by Coppin. The ball from Buddle. Finding Richardson helps it on neatly there. A little flick into the path of Cartwright. Cartwright plays it back to Richardson. And I think again, he could have had a little run down the right hand side. Clever footwork there from Hooks. Finds Cartwright. Cartwright running in field now. Finds Mullen. Mullen cross to the left, where he finds Jordan Watson, who has been incessant down that left wing all evening. Richardson laying it off to Dale. Dale gets it out of his feet. His Hooks in the area. This is the chance, and he takes it. It's 3-3 to Blyth Spartans. Neal Hooks with the equaliser, and the pressure just a little bit too much for North Shields as we come to the end of the game. And this one could be getting for extra time now, Lucan. He took it brilliantly, Neal Hooks. I did say he'd scored against League Town from a similar position last season. And he's come on the super sub to do it again here. 3-3. And he's been my man of the match today, certainly. Dale's going to have a chance to whip this one in. Away, just ahead of Maguire. Cartwright heading into the path of Hooks, and it comes down. Cartwright, that's a wonderful ball off the edge of the boot. Now here's Richardson in the area, and he's looped it over the keeper. And over the top of the crossbar, very close there from Michael Richardson. Built his Coppin across to Ormston. Ormston comes to the edge of the area. They're not closing him down. There's two over on the right-hand side. Donison pings it into the penalty area, headed away by Buddle. Holmes backtracks to the left-hand side to pick it up, and now finds somebody coming forward, and there's a shot here for Carr! And the space just opened up in front of him. You could see it so clearly from up here. It just gave him far too much room in front of goal, and he just curled it into the top corner of Adam McHugh's goal. It's a wonderful finish, but Spartans' defence really let themselves down the road. Again, far too much space. And now Shields aren't in any hurry to get this corner taken. They have now taken it. Dean Holmes playing it back to Ormston. You could just sense there was one extra ball in this, and there was a free kick here. Cartwright recklessly diving in. Really stupid challenge to make there when your time is so precious. And Shields have a chance to run the clock down again here. And there goes the full-time whistle. It's North Shields day. They've taken it from Blyth Spartans. Clutched it right at the end. And been a sensational match, really, hasn't it? 4-3 in the cup final. It's to and fro, and the effort just didn't seem to be there from Blyth in the second half.
And another disappointing end for Blyth Spartans, losing out 4-3 to North Shields in the Senior Cup final.
They're out of the cup, they're out of the league, nothing to play for now as the season draws to a close.
It's got down to the 90th minute and again they conceded in the last couple of minutes of the game.
It's a very disappointing one for Tom Wade's men, given it promised so much and they led the league for so long. But they'll come back next season, be plenty of changes around Croft Park in the summer and Blyth will be back with a bang come September.
Again, that's enough for me though anyway.
But for now, this is it from Luke Bidwell for Blyth Spartans TV.
Hope you had a good season, and this is Clinton Forde reporting for Blyth Spartans TV.